Hello students, today we are going to see chapter number 11, that is bank reconciliation statement of standard 11 commerce subject account. So today again we are going to see one more sum related to Adler's method. Let's see illustration number 3. Passbook of Kailash showed a credit balance of rupees 30,000 on 31st 3/15, which does not agree with the bank as per his cashbook. The following information is obtained by the comparing cashbook and passbook. Prepare bank reconciliation statement of Kailash from this information. So here it is given to us, that is the balance as per passbook, and it is the credit balance. That means we have to start from the passbook. So let's start credit balance as per passbook. So it is also called bank balance, and bank balance is of rupees 30,000. So here it is 30,000. Now let's see the first transaction. Check of rupees 10,000 was drawn and recorded in cash book, but by mistake it was not handed over to creditor. This check is found out from the drawer of table. So here what happened, that the check is written, that means it is recorded in the cash book, and it is not recorded in the passbook. So here check of rupees 10,000, which is already written in the cash book but not written in the passbook. So when we are giving check, the balance of the passbook supposed to be down. So here we have to less that amount. So here we have to less that amount from the balance. So that number one transaction, cash check drawn but not recorded in the passbook. So that is check written. And recorded in cash book and not handed over to creditor. And the check is of rupees 10,000. So that we are going to deduct from the balance of cash. Now let's see the transaction number 2. A check of rupees 30,000 is banked on 28/3/15, for which credit is given by bank on 1/4/15. So check which is deposited in the bank, but credit is given after the 31st 3/15. So that if we want to tally, that we have to add the same amount in the balance of bank, that is in the balance of passbook. So then we have to add it. So for that transaction number 2, and for that check deposited, but not credited by them. And the amount is a 30,000. Now let's see the third transaction. Third transaction is a bank has paid rupees 20,000 for insurance premium, for which Kailash received information on 2/4/15. So bank has given the insurance premium, that is the expense for the Kailash, and which wasn't known by Kailash. So it is not recorded in the cash book, and it is recorded in the passbook. So because of that, the balance of the bank will be reduced. That we have to add it. So the balance as per passbook and cash book will be same. So third इंश्योरेंस प्रीमियम पेड बाय बैंक. Not recorded in cash book. So that will be 20,000. Now the fourth one transaction is a rupees 30,000 are deposited by customer directly in the bank, which is unrecorded in the cash book. So because of the 30,000 directly deposited in the bank, the cash balance is already increased, but it is not recorded in the cash book. So here we have to reduce that amount from the passbook so that the balance will be same. So four number amount directly deposited. By customer not recorded in the cash book but unrecorded in cash book, so that will be amount will be 30,000. Now, let's see transaction number 5. Interest of rupees 1,000 is credited in passbook by bank, which is remain unrecorded in the cash book. So, it is bank interest which is recorded directly deposited in bank account, which is not recorded in the cash book. So, if we are going to less, means we are going to deduct from the bank balance, then the same, then the balance will be same. Fifth number, interest credited by bank. But unrecorded in cash book. So here the amount is a 1,000 rupees. Now let's see the sixth number. A check of rupees 60,000 which was deposited in bank is dishonored and this information is received on 2/4/15. So when the check is dishonored, for that we already record in the cash book, but in the passbook it is not credited. So here if you want to make the amount same, we have to add in a passbook. So for that we have to write in a BRS check dishonored, which is which is not credited in the passbook. Check dishonored. But unrecorded in cash book. So that will be 60,000. Now let's see transaction number 7. Check is of rupees 10,000 were issued, but out of this check of 8,000 only presented for payment till 31/3/15. So here we have issued some checks. See here where word is used. That means the check is not only one. There are few checks that is issued. Total amount is a 10,000. And from that only the check of 8,000 is presented in the bank. That means 2,000 check is not presented in the bank. So here it is recorded in the cash book but not recorded in the passbook. So here we have to deduct from the BRS, but the amount will be 2,000 because 10 out of 10,000, 8,000 check is already presented. That means 2,000 check is not present rate. So here we have to make the entry with 2000 only. So seven number. Check issue. Check issued but not presented for primary. So that will be, the amount will be 2000 here, 10,000 minus 8,000. So the amount will be 2000. Okay, now the eighth number, check of rupees 50,000 were deposited in the bank, but out of this bank has given credit of only 30,000 till 31st 3 15. So here check deposited but not credited by bank, that means we have to add that amount. So eighth number, check deposited but not credited by bank. So here the amount will be 50,000 minus 30,000. Balancing amount will be 20,000. That we have to write here. Okay. Now, number 9. A check of rupees 8,000 was deposited in the bank but was left unrecorded in the cash book. So the check is already deposited in the bank. That means balance as per passbook is already increased and it is not recorded in the cash book. So here we need to make the balance less by that amount so that the both balance will be same. So for that we have to deduct the amount. Check deposited but not recorded. In cash book. So that will be 8,000. Now let's see number 10. Bank charges and commission of rupees 2000 are debited by bank in the passbook of Kailap for which no entry is passed in the cash book. So here bank has debited bank interest and bank charges. That means in the from the passbook it is already deducted but it is not deducted in the cash book. So here we have to add the same amount in the passbook amount so the amount will be tabled. So here we are going to add bank charges and commission debited by bank but not recorded in cash book and the amount is 2000. So for that, now let's make the total of this and total of that. So here 30,000, 20,000, 60,000, 20,000 and 2000, that will be 1,32,000. And in that we are going to add 30,000, so that will be 1,62,000. Here 10,000, 30,000, 1,000, 2,000, 8,000, total will be 51,000. So that we are going to deduct. So the balance will be 1,11,000. So this will be bank balance as per cash book. So student, You may note down this in your notebook. Thank you for watching this video.